أما بعد، قال الله تبارك وتعالى في قرآنه المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: خير البرية نذر إلي، خير البرية نذر إلي، ما أنت إلا يا طه كنز العطية، ما أنت إلا يا طه كنز العطية. خير البرية نذر إلي، خير البرية نذر إلي، ما أنت إلا يا طه كنز العطية، ما أنت إلا يا طه كنز العطية. يا بحر فاضل وتاج عادل، يا بحر فاضل وتاج عادل، جد لي بوصل يا حبيبي قبل المنية، جد لي بوصل يا حبيبي قبل المنية. خير البرية نذر إلي، خير البرية نذر إلي، ما أنت إلا يا طه كنز العطية. All praise be to Allah Azza wa Jal, our creator, our sustainer, and the bestower of infinite mercy. And may salat and salam, peace and blessings be upon our Habib, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, today we are all gathered here for Eid al-Adha, 1445 Hijri. And we are gathered here for what? We are gathered here for Eid al-Adha, the second Eid of the year out of the two Eids. And the first Eid being? First Eid being Eid al-Fitr, commencing at the Eid al-Adha. Commencing at the end of Ramadan, this is the second Eid, known as Eid al-Adha, Eid al-Adha, and it is also known as the Eid of Sacrifice, the Eid in which millions of sheep, goats, cows, etc. have been sacrificed, the Eid where this meat has been taken and it has been distributed to the poor people. But where do these practices originate from? Where do they come from? Where do they stem from? Where have they come from? The practice of the sacrifice, the practice of the qurbani, it comes from the defining event which occurred at the time of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. It comes from which Nabi's time? Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. The time where Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, he went to his son. His son was Nabi Ismail alayhi salam. When his son was a small child, he went to him. And what did he do? He told his son about a dream he saw. He saw a dream. And he told his son about the dream. And the dream was where our creator Allah tabarak wa ta'ala asked him to sacrifice what is most beloved to him. This being what is most beloved to him? His son. This is being what is most dear to him? His son. In Surah Safat, ayah 102, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he declares here, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. فلما بلغ معه السعي قال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى قال يا أبت افعل تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. And when his son was old enough to walk with him, he said, يا بني. He said, Ya Bunayya, my son, Inni ara fil manami, I have seen in a manam, in a dream, Anni adbahuka, that I am slaughtering you, فانظر ماذا ترى. So see what you think. So Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام, he has seen in a dream where he is slaughtering his son. So he asks his son Ismail عليه السلام what he thinks about this. Ismail عليه السلام, he replies, يا أبت فعل تؤمر, يا أبت فعل, oh my father, do it. ما تؤمر, what you are commanded. Oh my father, do what you are commanded. ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. ستجدني, you will find me إن شاء الله, by the will of Allah, من الصابرين, of the patient. So what do we learn from this ayah? What do we understand from this ayah? What is the meaning of this ayah? We learn that Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was tested, he was examined by Allah tabarak wa ta'ala by being commanded to have to slaughter his beloved son. He was tested how? He was commanded to slaughter his beloved son. Ibadallah, we need to understand that this is not like sacrificing or giving up anything small or anything such as food, wealth, property. This is one's own family, his own son, his young son. Many people are reluctant to give up even these things, these worldly things, money, car, house, etc. Rather, this is the giving up of his son, his child, his most beloved asset. It is not like worldly asset, not like money, food. This is family, this is his son. And from this ayah, we also learn that Prophet Ismail alayhi salam, not even as an adult, he was a child, young child. He was steadfast enough, he was patient enough to go ahead with this, and he agreed. He was patient enough to what? To go ahead with this. Subhanallah Azza wa Jal. Such was the quality of Nabi Ismail alayhi salam, even during his childhood. So after this, both Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam and Nabi Ismail alayhi salam set out to go to Mina. But within this journey, there's also another significant story which I would like to go over and mention. So within this journey, Shaytan, Iblis, he went to Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam and told him that the dream he saw was from Shaytan, and it was Shaytan tricking him, Shaytan deceiving him in the dream. So what did Iblis try to do? He tried to convince Ibrahim alayhi salam that the dream wasn't from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that the dream was from Shaytan. It was a deception from Shaytan. This is what Iblis tried to trick him into. However, this attempt in itself was Shaytan's attempt trying to deceive Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. However, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he understood this, he got the message. So he pelted stones at him. He did what? He pelted the stones at him. And this action, it is still done to this day by our brothers and sisters who are doing Hajj currently at the Jamarat. Now when Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam and Nabi Ismail alayhi salam arrived at their destination at Mina, Ismail alayhi salam, he told his father to restrain his limbs with a rope so he couldn't move around or spill the blood onto Ibrahim alayhi salam. So then Ibrahim alayhi salam, he closed his eyes and started the sacrifice. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he declared, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ قَدْ verily صَدَّقْتَ, you have fulfilled الرُّؤْيَا, the vision. Verily, you have fulfilled the vision. Verily, you have fulfilled what? The vision, the dream. إِنَّا indeed كَذَلِكَ, thus نَجْزِي reward المحسنين. إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ, indeed we reward the muhsineen, the good doers. Thus from this we can see that Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, he had fulfilled the obligation, the command. And thus what happens? What does he see when he opens his eyes? He sees a giant ram in place instead of his son Nabi Ismail alayhi salam. So they sacrificed the ram instead. And this is where the current procession of sacrificing the qurbani comes from. But instead of sacrificing one's own child, instead of sacrificing a family member, etc., we sacrifice the animal, be it a cow, ram, etc. And by doing this, we also fulfill the sunnah of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. In a hadith in Tirmidhi, it was narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ما هذه الأضاحي يا رسول الله؟ What is the Qurbani, Ya Rasulullah, Messenger of Allah? Someone asked to Rasulullah.